Chef Loves, how are you?
I'm good. Sure, you are really cooking up a storm here today.
That's so true. I have so many things to do today.
Anything that I can help you with?
Well, technically, I have everything I need here. It's just that I'm looking for some oil, and I don't know where to find it.
Maybe down there.
Found it!
It looks like you have a lot of dishes to make today. Do you think this oil is going to be enough?
I hope so. I mean, I need to do so many things, and I don't have time to go get another one.
Okay, are you sure? I can try and make a plan, you know.
No. We need to start working right now. We'll just see what we'll do with this. I mean, something might work up. I just hope this oil is bottomless. Get it? Okay.
Actually, that reminds me of a Bible story.
Bible story? There's actually oil that's bottomless. I thought that was actually a joke.
No. Well, it actually happened in the Bible. But before I tell you the story, kids, don't you want to sing a song with us?
Yes!
Forget about the worries in your life. I mean the bare necessities. The Bible gives this recipe that brings the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, Jesus will be waiting for me to come back home. The birds are flying in the trees, the flowers look pretty in the fields. They don't work hard and they're not anxious. The Lord is faithful and He takes care of them too. So what about you? The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you. Look for the bare necessities. The Lord provides access to these. Forget about the worries in your life. I mean the bare necessities. With Jesus we can rest at ease. With just the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, Jesus will be waiting for me to come back home. The birds are flying in the trees, the flowers look pretty in the fields. They don't work hard and they're not anxious. The Lord is faithful and He takes care of them too. So what about you? The bare necessities of life will come to you. Necessities, the Lord provides access to these. Forget about the worries in your life. I mean the bare necessities. With Jesus we can rest at ease. With just the bare necessities of life. Oh, with just the bare necessities of life.
Whoa, that song always cheers me up. I love it. Okay. So let me tell you the story of what happened to the bottomless oil. Okay. Now, remember Elijah? A few weeks ago, we learned about Enoch and he was taken up to heaven. So was Elijah. And Elijah had been the main prophet. And when he was taken up to heaven, he left Elisha, who took over his now role as the prophet in Israel. And Elisha was doing amazing miracles for God. And the one day, Elisha encountered a widow and her son. Now, a widow is a lady who lost her husband because he died. And they had nothing left. You see, when the husband died, there wasn't money. And she had no more money left. But they still had lots of things they had to pay. Now, all she had in her house of value was a little bit of oil. Now, oil was really precious back then. And it signified that you would have a lot of money. But she only had a little bit, and that was all she had left. So she thought that they were going to die of hunger because they had nothing. And Elisha told her that she has to go and get all the empty jars from her neighbors. Now, they weren't little jars. They were big jars. But what was going to happen to empty jars? Well, God did an amazing miracle. You see, Elisha told her to start pouring the oil into the jars. She poured a little bit, little bit, little bit into each jar. And as she kept pouring, well, the oil kept topping up and topping up and topping up until all the jars were full of oil. Isn't that amazing? From a little, little bit of oil, God multiplied it, and she had enough money. She could sell the oil and had enough money to pay all her debts, and they could live off that money. You see, God always provides for all our needs. That's who He is. And we can go to Him with anything we could ever need because He is our provider. Isn't that amazing?
It actually is amazing. I mean, God is such a provider. I mean, from little oil to so many jars, and just filling it up like that until it actually even overflowed.
Exactly.
I love how He always provides for His people.
Absolutely. Boys and girls, don't forget that God is our provider and you can go to Him with absolutely anything you ever need. And remember, He's never too busy for you and always wants to hear from you.
And speaking about that, look at the dishes we actually ended up making.
Oh my word, and there's a little bit of oil left over.
You know what, boys and girls, this actually teaches me that Jesus is actually our provider. I can't wait to see you guys again next week. Same time, same place.
Bye.